Okay, we'll just continue with the discussion sessions. So, see, basically what we would say that, you see, we have covered, let's say, if we go back to day one, so we started with equivalent force couple system. So then we actually did the 2D equilibriums for frames and machines, then 3D equilibrium. Then we did the truss, then friction, virtual work, energy methods, and structural dynamics, okay? So as we have seen that, intention was to really deliver some concepts. Mostly we tried to give, solve a lot of problems in this workshop, but idea was to deliver the concepts. And basically what we really tried to do is, draw all the free body diagrams. See, that is what we started with, that free body diagram will be the fundamentals of everything. So we started with that, and we have seen that once we have a clear free body diagram, then we can solve it using simply force balance and moments balance. And there were a bit deviations when it comes to, let's say, virtual work and energy methods, because those are also, solution approach that we have followed to solve equilibrium problems. Okay. Now, we think that, yes, it was a bit exhaustive because that is what we do in IIT to all our first year students. It's a rigorous exercise process that we basically go through. And as we said that we limit our discussions mostly to statics and then touch upon dynamics. Because various disciplines have actually, taken the dynamics whatever way they want for their students. So we have not really covered the kinematics and, let's say, curvilinear motion, rectilinear motion, impulse momentum, and so on and so forth. Okay. So we'll just quickly start off, with the discussions. So if you have any suggestions, how to go about this, if you have any special requirements, we can just hear from you directly. And we can see if that can be incorporated during the main workshop. So anyone is please welcome to, give your comments what to do during the main workshop. Please go ahead. Yeah.
Sir, I belong to Tamil Nadu. There, particularly on behalf of my student I am talking, the syllabus, if you take, there are five units. Out of the five units, here in this presentation, I got that. Two topics, if it is taught in the main workshop, that will be useful for my students. The number one, moment of inertia, mass moment of inertia. Because the entire third unit in our syllabus is that only. And fourth unit, sir, we are having kinetics of particles. That also not covered here in this forum. If these two topics are incorporated, that because it is a two modules there in our syllabus, if it is included, definitely we are more helped by you, and our students will be getting benefit out of this.
Oh, mostly you are saying moment of inertia.
Yes, sir. I say centroid,
moment of inertia,
mass moment of inertia,
and kinematics.
Kinematics of particles. And we are having one more topic also, dynamics of particles, right? But these two are incorporated, means that is good for us, sir. Try to do that. Thank you.
Good afternoon to all the dignitaries on the dais and off the dais. Myself, T. Murali Krishna, working as Associate Professor in Geetanjali Engineering College, Nellur, belongs to JNTU Anantapur. What I am going to suggest is, in our curriculum also, we are having the same syllabus suggested by just my following this person. Sir, we are having mass moment of inertia, centroid, and the moment of inertia of plane bodies, plane geometry figures, followed by we are having the kinematics, kinetics, and also vibration concepts, sir. So if you incorporate those concepts in the main.
Sir? Vibration is already done.
We are having the very basic
moment
of
inertia,
very
basic kinematics.
That simple pendulum, torsion pendulum, torsion pendulum. So those concepts, sir. Especially our students are feeling some difficulty in the basics of, even in kinematics and kinetics also, we are having basics, sir.
Okay.
Very, very basic things, sir. That is connected bodies. So the equations for analysis of connected bodies and simple applications of projectiles, especially. Projectiles and followed by vibrations also, sir. Simple pendulum, torsion pendulum. So those basics we are having, sir. So if you provide, if you include that basics also, it is helpful to our students.
So you are in mechanical, right?
No, sir, civil engineering,
you are
sir.
In civil, okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah, moment of inertia, we can...
Okay, point taken, yeah.
Point taken, yeah. So we can. Anyone?
Yes, anyone else has any observation, comments, suggestions, please. We'd like to hear from you.
Myself, Sidramappa IIT from KL Engineering College, Karnataka. Sir, first of all, I am very much thankful to you, both of you, in which we are also teaching, but we are not going to that kind of depth. First, I have to accept it as a teacher. So for that, I am very much thankful to both of you, sir.
Thanks.
So you went really some of the fundamentals, especially in the friction. So the slipping, where the number of slips and all are supposed to take place. So that usually it has been nicely explained by Professor Inamdar. And also the Banerjee sir has explained in very fundamentals of today's this vibrations. Many of the students are, we people are not knowing, so that has been explained. But apart from that, so my suggestion to this workshop is regarding, so the here we have gathered across the country, but almost all, I think the syllabus is same, except one or two chapters here and there. But at what depth we are supposed to teach to our students? Because you people are looking at the IIT level, here the stuff is different and the students are also having a different caliber. But we have to look at the common or average and below average students. How to go ahead and what depth we have to stop and all those things. Finally, what we are interested is the students should love the subject. If I make it difficult by taking some difficult examples, so definitely they will feel it that when it is a tough subject or something like that. So please look into that one and give us suggestions during your main workshop. So at what level and how much level we have to teach? That is one suggestion. Of course, CGMI is another which important chapter is there that is required for the civil engineering throughout there, even at the higher semester and all. So please look into this these two aspects, sir.
Okay, thanks. So point well taken. Two observations I want to make. That since this was a coordinator's workshop, and all the teachers were experienced, that was one of the prime reasons we decided that we will take the course to as high a level as possible. Okay, that was the first reason. Okay, because what we had also realized is that if we want to teach quantity X to students, then it's a good idea if you know at least like 2X. Okay, then for example, we can give some perspective to the students. So what we can do is when we deliver the lectures in December or November, December, during the end of those months, what we will do is that the level of the problems done, we will take down a bit, okay, but what we can do is that we can do that in more details than that was done in the workshop. Okay, we'll do any problem we take, the level will not be as much for most of the problems, but we'll do them in much greater details, and that's what our plan was all along. Because we go at a higher level at a much faster pace, and then afterwards when it comes to the main workshop, we just decide that, okay, we'll go one level lower and do things much more exhaustively. Point well taken. And second point, okay, so pardon me if I say something presumptuous, but you made a point that the end goal of any course is that a student should enjoy the course. But one thing we have also realized is that goal is truly served when the professor also enjoys the course. Okay? So if professor doesn't enjoy the course, there is no way the students will enjoy. So we are just trying to put some fun in the course, that there is some challenge. Because what happens is that if the professor feels that, okay, they know everything about a topic, then there is no thrill, there is no learning. So the entire idea was that we seek out newer and newer problems, more and more difficult problems, so we challenge ourselves and enthuse ourselves, get ourselves more enthusiastic about the course. And in the meanwhile, like when we teach that course so enthusiastically, very likely, the students will also really like it. Okay, so that was the entire goal, okay, in teaching this coordinators workshop. But your point is well taken, that depending on the requirements of your college or most of the colleges around the country, what we can do is, yeah, so for example, a couple of topics about the moment of inertia of planar bodies, okay, kinematics, impulse momentum, little bit of torsional vibration, okay, I think that's not difficult to incorporate, okay, so, but we have to cut some topics from whatever we did here today, and we can incorporate them, okay, it's not an issue, okay, we will look into it and try our best to take your suggestions into account.
Sir, one more point is,
yes, please.
In the analysis of CES, we are having actually three methods, sir. Method of joints, method of sections. The third method is the method of tension coefficients. Method of tension coefficients. It is somewhat related to vector approach, sir.
To
so
what?
By considering the coordinates of each joint, considering the coordinates with respect to one support, by taking the coordinates of each joint, we can prepare the coefficients called tension coefficients.
Okay.
So by using those tension coefficients also, we can calculate the forces in the different members in the frame.
Okay, so this the terminology that you are using tension coefficients, okay, I'm not aware of that terminology because it is not used in most standard texts, for example, or in any standard practice it is not used. Okay, but we will have a look at that. But what I'm just trying to say is that if there are some highly specialized topics, that will be difficult to incorporate. But the more broader topics, as mentioned, okay, that we will definitely try to take into account.
One more is in friction, we are having the friction developed in screw jacks also, sir.
Oh, screw jacks also?
Simple screw jacks and differential screw jacks also, sir.
Okay, so
bearings you do? Bearings?
Sir?
Journal bearings?
No, bearings is not there, sir.
Not
most
there.
Of the.
So, how many universities do pulley friction or belt friction?
Belt friction is there.
And screw jacks?
Yes, sir. Tamil Nadu, we have screw jacks, belt friction.
Belt friction we discussed, right? Belt friction was covered in detail.
Okay, screw jack was.
So, we can discuss the screw jacks.
It's not an issue. We can solve two, three problems, discuss the basic concepts. Not an issue at all.
See.
Rising off load. By using screw jack.
Rising the self locking, lowering, okay, we can definitely incorporate that. Not an issue.
So idea again in the main workshop would be, you know, to limit ourselves to certain number of problems.
Yes, sir.
It is going to be very slow pace. It is not as fast as we have done here because it is actually being delivered to the students. So we have to make sure that we kind of, you know, do problems, but that will not be more problems we are not going to solve. We are only going to solve, let's say, 2 to 3 problems, and we are going to discuss those problems in details, okay? So that all the concepts are actually delivered to the students. And we are going to incorporate, I think, as you are suggesting, some of the topics will be definitely incorporated, okay? We are just noting it down, and we'll incorporate, okay?
Excuse me, sir, let me introduce myself first. I am Krishnamurthy from KSR College of Technology, Tiruchengode. Situated in Tamil Nadu, west part of Tamil Nadu. I would like to mention one point. That is, so far we have lengthy discussions related to engineering mechanics, but there is no demonstrations. That like friction concept, if you take friction concept, friction is independent of area of contact. It's supposed to be demonstrated. How to demonstrate? This kind of things will be incorporated in our workshop. Then the teaching community will benefit better. Demonstrations in how to calculate coefficient of friction, how to express that friction is independent of area of contact, independent of mass, this kind of laws, including laws. Very fundamental we are teaching, since we are teaching for the first year students. Some of the demonstrations may be included in our lecture.
Okay, so for example, we can incorporate some video demonstration. If you go on YouTube, for example, there are many videos which will demonstrate that.
It's available.
So what I personally feel is that key the logistics of these things, okay, it becomes very difficult to like take some students to the lab, okay, you to the lab or bring some equipment from there and do it. It's not particularly difficult also.
Not,
we can have a video demonstration.
I am not asking you to do such kind of difficult demonstrations. Very simple demonstrations like small demonstrations like area friction is independent of area of contact and then the angle of repose, how to demonstrate angle of repose.
We can do those things.
Yeah, we can.
Not
see.
All.
Sure.
Something may be demonstrated only in the laboratory, but many a thing, some fundamentals wherein we can demonstrate.
Okay, point taken.
Hello, sir. I'm Vagesh. I'm very happy that my alma mater is taking such a noble work to help the nation. My suggestion is the institute can go through the syllabus of all the universities, form a common syllabus, and then deliver the lectures. Instead of sticking to one university or IIT syllabus or something like that, you can take the syllabus of all the universities which are present in the country and make a common syllabus and then deliver your goods.
We already got inputs from all the representatives of India. Okay, so I think we already know what we need to do.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, my name is Arun. I'm from Srinarayana Gurugulam College of Engineering, Kerala.
Okay. Yeah.
This is specifically to the coordinator's workshop.
Yeah.
What I personally, it's not a personal feel because I have been discussing with the other faculties also. I feel that all the faculty fraternity would have been able to extract more from this workshop, provided the things, the problems that were being discussed in the class were at least given a day prior to us, so that we would at least few of us would have prepared. Those who feel themselves, those who are weak in some areas, they would have at least had some background work done so that everybody would have got equally benefited. So I don't know whether the same could be applied to the main workshop also. So please.
No, main workshops, you already have this Moodle login, right?
Okay.
You are given with a login.
Yeah.
So all the problems, you know, lecture notes, problems and solutions will be there.
Okay.
So you can again re-exercise those.
Yeah.
But as we said that we have to now kind of reorganize the, you know, syllabus.
Yeah.
Okay, so we are trying to kind of take out some of the problems. Let's say we'll take out some of the problems. And that time will be, you know, kind of taken care by other topics.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll try to reorganize the syllabus a little bit with some adjustment will be there.
And also another suggestion, okay, the entire point of the coordinator workshop is that now you are going to be the main person at your university. So for example, that now we are all doing this together. So it is not that we are the only ones who should do things. That when you go, if you feel that something is more important, that you can do that work yourself, because all the notes, everything that we discussed, okay, will be up in Moodle.
Yeah.
Okay, so you can take those notes, okay, then you can think that, okay, that these are the concepts I think my students should brush upon. Okay, and then you can also help us indirectly by doing that. But this point is well taken, that in the future, as and when we do this workshop again, okay, those slides, okay, we can provide a few days in advance so that interested students or interested coordinators can have a look at them and may benefit more from that.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thanks.
So I'm from West Bengal, and in my state, in engineering mechanics, we have strength of materials. And in strength of materials, we have different mechanical properties. How they are relating, these are included in our syllabus. And one thing I like to say that what professor has just said, that the books, I mean the syllabus should be uniform throughout this India. And one thing I want to say that some of the books have problems, different types of things that which is difficult for the students to realize. Some of the books do not have, we should discard or this, what should we say about those books? So what are the books we should follow, the students? And if you arrange some lectures for the students uniformly, I mean throughout this India, then the whole nation will be beneficial. That's my suggestion. And I'm really thankful to IIT Bombay and to you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, so just one thing I can say is, for it's a very unique case where in engineering mechanics they also do solid mechanics, at least in India, but abroad it is not uncommon. That, for example, they don't in many colleges, in many universities. Okay, for example, if you look at open courseware of MIT, under engineering mechanics for them essentially means solid mechanics. Okay, so the point is that this is the first time I heard that some college within India that also did solid mechanics or strength of material within engineering mechanics. Okay, so it may be very difficult to incorporate that into the main workshop. But the point about the textbooks. So many students or many coordinators asked me that what are the best textbooks and so on. Okay, I gave them a few lists. But the reason that, for example, I'm not saying that, okay, you should use this textbook, because I can say that there are good problems in this textbook, good problems in the other textbook. In some places, theory is good. In some places, for example, the theory that we teach, or for example, there are various concepts that we had discussed, which is not there in any textbook. This is, for example, what we had thought about, what we had learned. Okay, so that's why it is very difficult to say that, okay, that this is a textbook. Okay, this is the, like all the knowledge is inside and you will learn from here. So the idea of this workshop, what I felt is that all of us, okay, we learn to think by ourselves, decide that, okay, what is the best way to think about problems, what is the reasonable way to convey, depending on the caliber of the students, and then take our own call that what should be incorporated, what should not be incorporated, how should things be dealt with, and so on. But about having a uniform syllabus to the country, okay, that is definitely beyond our purview. Okay, we cannot do anything about that. There are various policy makers at various levels.
Can suggest to the universities.
Okay, I can suggest, of course.
No.
Okay.
Ultimately, some of these are policy decisions.
Yeah, I can suggest like many things to my kid also, okay, but she also doesn't listen. Okay. So if I can't convince my own kid, okay, I can say yes.
I'm Avadesh Sharma from MITS Gwalior. Sir, as we know, different universities is having the different syllabus. As far as our university concerned, we are having shearing force and bending moment chapter.
That is in strength of material.
For example, typically those topics are in strength of material.
So,
okay, but they are also there in engine mechanics textbook. See, the bottom line is this. Okay, let me emphasize this way.
Yeah.
So if everyone says that, okay, our university this topic, ours only this topic, we should cover this, we should cover that. So that's, I don't think, is the idea of this workshop. The idea is that we learn how to think. We learn how to do things. And then all the various specifics. Okay, you are well versed now. Okay, you are already an expert. You came here and you learned some things. Okay, the way we do it. So then you can incorporate everything and then you can teach accordingly. So what I would like to say is that even though I appreciate the point that everyone is making, I don't think that we can just go and decide, okay, that this topic I should teach, this topic also I should teach, so everything that we should teach. I don't think that's the point. The point is that all of us get enthused about the topic. Okay, we learn various things. Some things may not be covered, but I don't think, for example, that we need to go into every micro detail. Okay, we just teach a broad overview. Okay, there are some things, for example, dynamics, kinematics. Okay, I agree that should be taught. Why? Because those are basics. But all the various specific problems, okay, pardon me if I'm saying this, but I think the idea of this workshop, in my opinion, is not to go into every small problem, but give a very broad overview, because you will also have your own classes, right, at the end of it.
Like this, one more topic.
Yes.
Lifting machine.
What machine?
Lifting machine is also
wedges.
Yeah,
but
lifting machine.
We did wedge work problem, right? One of the wedge problems we did, for example.
So,
okay, we did not explicitly mention that, yeah. But
wedge was there.
Wedge was there, right? We solved one problem at least. Okay, and for example, I can give one problem as homework, and you could also solve, for example. So your point is well taken. We'll try to incorporate as much as we can.
Yeah.
But any small specific detail, I think it will be very difficult to cover. We can, for example, give a broad overview. Okay.
See, especially in this course, objective is to really deliver the concept of forces to the students. So don't deviate from that. One of the main objectives are really to deliver the concept of forces, how the free body diagram will be taken into account. And also we go with the, you know, work energy methods and those principles to tackle some of the problems. So we cannot really go to strength of materials at this point, and we have a dedicated course, solid mechanics, in the second year that takes care of all. But remember, this engineering mechanics knowledge again will be required there, because at first you think of force, then only you get into stress. Okay, so.
And there also won't be enough time. For
enough
example,
time will be not be there.
That to is cover also. Everything, but we'll try to incorporate your suggestions as well as we can.
Okay, sir, good afternoon.
All from that.
Sir, okay, I'm DS Lal from RC Patel Institute of Technology, North Maharashtra University. Maharashtra, Dulia. I want to know that what you are planning for the experimentations, because you have mentioned in the planning that you have made earlier. What are the experiment we have to perform, or are you planning for the generalization of experiments?
I don't think you mentioned experiments.
We did not mention, I think, experiments.
No,
in
no.
This.
We did not mention.
So I want to know from you that whether you are planning something for
no,
the
we are not
experiment
part.
It's too lesser time. There is too much to cover, and also incorporating experiments. Okay, I think it will be difficult. We will try to see.
Okay.
Okay, but I don't promise. I can't promise right now.
But through videos, see, students can learn also through videos. That is one thing. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So there are a lot of free materials available on the web. You see that NPTEL course also there. You can lot of lectures and demonstrations there also.
We'll try to get at least a collection of videos at the very least.
Okay. So we'll keep that in mind. We are noting down that some demonstration problem through videos, if we can do it. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yes. Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
I'm Dr. Rajan Varghese from KME Engineering College.
Okay.
Center of Kerala.
You can sit down, please. Yeah. You don't need to stand up.
It's only fact that different universities are following different syllabi. And it will be inhuman task to cover all the portions that are dealt with the various syllabi of different universities. So up to us, the learner coordinators, to rise up and cope up. So for example, center of gravity, I think we can do it.
That's one of the points I was trying to make. Okay.
Instead of arguing for common syllabus for the whole India, I don't know how that will be possible. That's one point. The second point was, you have dealt with some topics which are of concern of mechanical engineering stream. For example, belt friction, vibration. I suggest that if you had a faculty from the mechanical department, that you added flavor to this cake. You have done a very good job. I take this opportunity to congratulate the organizers for doing an excellent work. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Ashish from KIT Ghaziabad.
Let's sit down, please.
Yeah, actually, it is just my suggestion to you, and I think you'll take care of it. While solving numerical problems, it will be good if you, before coming onto the solution directly on the PowerPoint or something like that, it will be good if you just spare some time for us to solve, for students to solve during the main workshop, and then give a brief free body diagrams of it, then give some time like that.
So we try to do that in the tutorial, right, for example?
Yeah.
Okay, so we can have an extensive tutorial, okay? It's not a problem. And we are actually planning to have an extensive and an exhaustive tutorial at the end of every class, where whatever you are saying will be followed, and that's what precisely we do at IIT also.
Thank
lectures
you.
We discuss without too much contribution from the students, just some doubts. But in the tutorials, exactly we do it the way you suggested.
Right.
So we ask them that this is the problem, this is the idea, now you solve. And then we help them in between.
So overall, students will get more or less half an hour per problem to solve and discuss the issues, whatever they have. Okay.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. This is Victor Babu from Sanketika Vidya Parishat Engineering College, Visakhapatnam. First of all, I would like to thank you very much for giving this type of opportunity for us. So one thing I require is you have injected a lot of knowledge in our minds within short period. So we need to extract all these files by when we went to our college. So because we must be in a position to manage more than 50 participants in main workshop.
Mm-hmm.
So please give us best suggestions to manage how to extract our knowledge. Whichever the topics we have discussed.
Okay, so I thought that's what we did, but what we can do is that all the slides, okay, they will be provided to you.
Yes, yes.
Okay, and for example, what I can do is that after we go back, we can give a list of books, for example, that you can have a look at.
Okay, sir.
Okay, some of them, many of the books have Indian editions, so they are not very expensive. Some of the books are Western edition and they can be prohibitively expensive, but two or three books are available. They are Indian edition.
Okay.
Some second book reference was given.
Okay.
That
reference you had given, right?
Yeah. Medium and Breaks. We gave the three books actually.
Okay.
And all has Indian editions, so they are not expensive.
Okay.
Medium and Craig, B.R. and Johnston, and Sames. These are the three books. If you go to the introductory slides, it's already there in the module. Just look at the book links as well as some useful web links.
Okay.
Where you can yourself register and kind of go through the course.
And there is one thing which I want to suggest, that there is no substitute for sitting down and thinking yourself.
Okay, sir.
Okay, whatever you do, there is no substitute for that. Okay, you have to sit down, spend hours together to understand just one problem in all possible details, what can be done. Okay, that like any suggestion will ultimately boil down to that. That we have just we have just shown you that this is the way in which you would like to think. But the ultimate thinking to convince yourself, it has to be done from your side only.
Okay,
and we had spent hours together trying to figure things out. Not that, like, for example, I'm perfect or anything, but better than what I was before, and that's the best we can hope for. Okay, so idea is that you just get down, just figure out by yourself. Okay, if you can't figure out, read some book. If not, ask your colleague. Okay, there are so many avenues. Okay, but ultimately you have to get down, okay, and think yourself, and then convince yourself that, okay, this is the way I want to solve this problem, this is the way I understand, this is the way I want to convey this to the students, and I think this is the best. And keep an open mind and improve if we see something better.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, yes. My name is Sachin Jasuja. I'm from API IIT Panipat, sir. Sir, I just want to say that can you add some references to the problems, the books and whatever the sources you are using, so that sometimes it happens that the student or the person is not able to solve at the moment that you are offering. Maybe 30 minutes are not sufficient for a person.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you add some reference, then it will be easy for him to refer the solution or the book.
Yeah, some problems are designed by us. So that is, let's say it's like that. But some problems are directly taken from these three books we named, no?
Yeah.
So, but I think we can do that. Okay?
We can do that. So I mean, each problem, we can just refer easier, that this is the book we are referring to.
Yes.
But some problems, yes, we have made ourselves. So that is also
That cannot be sourced, no, sir. That is okay. But those are taken from the books. They can, there the references can be added.
Sure, not a problem.
Thank you,
but
sir.
It is not clear if I had some
orally mentioned, okay, but I think it is a valid point.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll add those references. Okay, that this problem taken from what book?
Good afternoon, sir. Myself, Julius J. Singh, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, St. Xavier's Catholic College of Engineering, Kanyakumari. So I congratulate the organizing team for organizing such a nice program, IIT Bombay, and the professors also. And I have positive points and some negative points also. So you have arranged the program in a nice way, and to transfer the knowledge from IIT Bombay to all over the India. So you have accommodated most of the staff from various states of India and provided all the facilities in a nice way, and the hospitality is also good. But I want to suggest in the negative way, don't mistake me. I am a writer of few books like Engineering Graphics, Basic Civil and Mechanical Engineering, and Workshop. All the three books are in multicolor. The intention behind is most of the students in India nowadays very poor background, like in education. So what you are teaching is based on IIT, Anna University, and most of the famous universities. Only the bright students only enter the IITs and other top level universities. Nowadays, more than 5,000 engineering colleges are there in the India, and more than 80% of the colleges, they are recruiting only very average students only. So keep in their mind, the students' mindset, I found some idea in myself and created the textbook in a multicolor so that the students can, once they turn up the pages, some curiosity will come to turn other pages, and once they turn up the pages, they will have some time spending on the subject and book, and finally they will have the interest on the subject. Okay? So in that mindset, I am planning of writing the engineering mechanics books also in the next year, within the next year. And what I am suggesting it, what you are teaching here is based on Baron Johnson, some Marion Johnson, and the 1970 edition. Why don't you prepare some material? You can refer the book, but why don't you prepare the material in an animated way so that instead of giving all the picture all of a sudden in the screen, why don't you give the animation effort step by step so that all the observer can understand the concept easily and transfer the knowledge to the students also. Since we are a coordinators, not a problem. So you will, in the main workshop, you will directing the 10,000 teachers. If all the 10,000 teachers are benefited with the workshop, the lakhs of students will be benefited. If the 10,000 staff are not benefited, the lakhs of students will be also not benefited. So the idea behind the coordination with the government of India and IIT Bombay, transferring the knowledge from IIT level to lower level institutions. So try in that way, try to have some animated and colorful effect of, and a big sum, instead of taking the Xerox from the scan from the test book, it is not visible and readable. So you can have a big drawings and mistake-free presentation. It will guide the students more effectively. So thank you. One more suggestion, and even a good presentation, it may not stressed beyond 1 hour. So you are keeping all of us from 8:30 to 6. It is a more stressful. So in the future workshop, please try to understand our pain also. Try to wind up at least before 4 o'clock every day. This is my personal suggestion. Thank you.
Okay, so let me answer it, okay? In a little bit of a humorous vein. So if we take all your suggestions in mind, okay, we can as well solve world hunger problem, okay? So about all the animations and everything, okay, we try our best, okay? It is one step at a time, okay? Since you are the coordinators, my suggestion to you is that why don't you all take one problem, you work on the animation, and then give it to us and say, okay, why don't you discuss it this way, okay? Rather than putting all the onus on our shoulders, since we are co-learners, okay, why don't we all do it together? Okay, you can do that. If you, for example, have some suggestions, then you do it, you don't make any mistake. Okay, why don't you correct my mistakes and tell me, okay, you do it this way, rather than saying you do it. Okay, you help me. Okay, then I take your point. Okay, because we have only so much time. This is only one part of our work. Okay, like a lot of our part goes also in research and many other activities. Okay, so we do only so much. Of course, everybody has to improve. But the point is that since we are talking about the future of the nation, okay, we are all equal stakeholders in that. So let us take equal responsibility and convey it to us. Okay, we will try our best. Okay, what I suggest is that your points are well taken, but you guys also help us. Okay, then that will be great. Okay, if you say that only you have to do it. Okay, I don't think it works that way.
We already have the collaboration.
Yeah, sure.
So you tell.
See, from now on,
you means not just you, okay? It's not a personal observation. You means everyone here.
What happened, even previous workshop that happened, previous workshop, what happened also through other courses, the participants went back, they prepared the, problems in a very nice way, even sent back to us.
Yes.
And we are able to even take some problems and just present to the students. See, that way we also get more materials out of it. It's a mutual benefit. That is why, this workshop is all about that. It is not that always we can do it. I mean, we try to do it whatever we can, with the time constraints and time frame we have. Sure, that will be...
It's not an issue.
That is one of the very good suggestions, actually, because presentation has to be in a very nice way. But we do have a limited, time to work around, And as long as, what we thought, okay, concepts are delivered in a genuine way, it's fine. But yes, the presentation is also required, in a good manner.
So we take have one suggestions.
Yeah.
So I'm Mohan from Tamil Nadu.
Mm-hmm.
So actually you are suggested foreign author books. Already they told some Beer and Johnson's, James, okay. Merriam,
okay.
Like that. But most of the self-finance college, they are following local authors. So my suggestion is, so foreign author is good. It is all or no. But we are struggling to understanding the given figure to free body diagram. So in local author, they are directly given diagram is free body diagram, like a force diagram like that. After that, we are converting procedure like that. But here, practically, so ladder, some friction means one person standing on the ladder. So they are given 3D pictures, the practical application they given. So we are struggling, what is my point of view means, so how to convert that practical figure to free body diagram? Mm-hmm. So that is, you have to communicate to both authors.
I think there are some problems we tried to do that. For example, I had shown in one few of the slides, for example, that how to convert a real life problem into a caricature so that it can be used for finding problems. Even for example, there are a few problems, I believe, I discussed this approach. But your point is well taken, that we can emphasize it even more. Okay, it's a well proper point, okay, and well taken care.
Thank you.
It will be taken care of.
Because ultimately, yes. It's always other way around, that you actually try to design a real world problem and you make a caricature of that real world problem to simplified model. And that was the first day of the discussions.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Yeah.
Myself, Govind Mari, from Vidyalankara Institute of Technology, Mumbai. We learned a lot many things over here. Already many suggestions, many discussion is already there related to the syllabus and all those things. Mine is little bit different. I learned a lot many things over here, especially energy. Already many times we have calculated that one, learned from different books, but now I experienced it from you people. Lot many energy, yes, tons of energy we have experienced now. Now, as per the law of energy, energy cannot be destroyed, either created, but it can be transferred in another form. So indirectly, you transferred some energy to us.
I hope it was more light than heat. Okay, though we had a lot of heat also.
Yes.
Okay,
now, actually, one more important thing I would like to suggest. Actually, this is not a suggestion. This is a request, sir.
Okay.
I heard somewhere, read somewhere, that teaching is a fine art of imparting knowledge without possessing it.
Okay, I would like to know your source, but still.
Who told that?
No,
but yeah, okay.
Actually, that is a...
It's very zen.
Yes, it is a very important part of a teaching. So, I would like to suggest or request, so concentrate on that art. That is a methodology of a teaching, technique of a teaching, various tricks.
Mechanics
of the solving the questions, then the sticking the just chalk and board. Those things are important for us. So in next session, you may add these things, that is the different tricks, different ways of teaching, methodologies, and all those things.
Okay, so not a problem. Okay, you should thank these guys maybe.
Because already a lot much discussion is there related to the syllabus. I'm not going to add so many points in that one because that is not possible to sort out. Different universities are there. There are different rules are there. Different pressures are there from different directions. We can't make system in equilibrium.
Sir, I'm Alghu Bose and I'm from Techno India, Calcutta. So the observation is, the observations which are already discussed, I'm not going into that. But I'll say something which is pertaining to me. So the other coordinators should not feel that it is our view. So I am teaching this subject for around 10 years. And while coming here, this is my ex-college. I am an ex-student of this college. I have done M.Tech from this college. So I thought that, okay, let me go and have the course along with. I can see my college and I can just... be a little bit, nostalgic. So after completing the course, I found that it really added a lot of value to me. It is really, and yesterday also I was talking to one of my colleagues there in Calcutta. I told that when I came here, the expectation was not very much, I'm telling you very frankly. But after the finishing the course, I have seen that I have learned a lot of things and which has added value to my career and that I will transmit down the line. So I am very much thankful to you, both of you.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks.
Good afternoon. Okay,
I think we'll have one last question, I think, because we are almost...
Last question, sir.
Okay, yes.
So myself, Professor Chaudhary VA from Pune, Maharashtra.
Okay.
So in dynamics, if possible, add some topics like rectilinear motion, projectile motion, and curvilinear motion.
Don't worry, we are going to add those kinematics.
At least some part of that. It's not everything. At least some basics will definitely add. Okay, no problem. No question about that. Yeah.
Excuse me, sir.
So, more or less, we are thinking to add this moment of inertia. That is one part, centroid calculations. The second one would be kinematics of particles. So, that is what we are going to add. And screw jack.
Okay.
These three would be okay. And we take out some of the materials in the sense that we are not really going to go through rigorous amount of problems as we have done here. So we are going to make maybe 2-3 problems per topics, but students will be given, let's say, half an hour times to solve this. Okay, so half an hour time will be given per problems, and it will be discussed during the main workshop in details. And it will be, as he said, it is going to be animations and all that, that every one of you are going to help us, okay? So when you are going to go back, if you can convert those problems in a good way, we'll be very happy to take those. Okay.
Everyone of us will be having some points to give us a feedback. Tell us, give our feedback in a page of paper.
You know, there is, I think, this link will be there, no, from now on. The feedback form is there. That is right now feedback. But what is happening, you are going to, you know, kind of interactive from now. When you go back, you can actually send us feedback also. That is not an issue.
The last one.
Okay.
So the textbooks, what has referred by the...
We are PPS.
No, no, sir. I'm not asking any question or like that. The textbook what referred by the professor Biren Johnson is one of the best book. And for the 8th edition, you will get the exercise solution, everything available in the net. If you have any doubt, you can refer those solutions.
Okay.
Biren Johnson,
for 8th edition, for all the exercise problem, you have the solutions available in the internet.
It is 9th edition, right?
8th edition. 9th also is on, I think.
9th also is on. You can get the exercise solutions.
Yeah, I have found
free from the website. You can directly download those solutions from the website.
Okay, you may have to request the publisher, I think. Okay, you may do that and then get it.
And so you can get the full exercise solutions. So you can refer.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
Okay then, so...
Close this right now.